You open it all the way up, it starts to break the door away. Then they're going to put it through the door, pull the door out of the way. You see Morgan on the same side over there. They're working against the structure of the car, causing the door to pop out of the way that it doesn't normally do. Once they get the doors out of the way, the hinges are going to come off. So they're going to get out some other tools that they got over there. And you see the yellow lines sitting over here. Those are hydraulic cutters. They're going to take those in there and cut the hinges. And then they actually cut the bolt, the nail bolt, which is holding the door shut. So you notice the driver hasn't stopped over here. He's still working. He's got all sorts of tools that he's trying to get ready for these guys. Because he's trying to stay one step ahead of them. So the next thing that they're going to do is he wants to make sure he has all the tools ready. So he knows everything that they're going to do. And he's getting everything ready. So as soon as they're finished with this, they've got everything that they need next. Dave Peruti right there, this guy is working in front of the white helmet. He is cutting the hinges, so he's going to cut those hinges off and actually cut right through them, and the whole door is going to come off here. Demonstration, we're just going to show you everything that we do here. So they're going to take both doors off the car, they're going to take the hood off the car, and they're going to actually move the dashboard away. Because if you were to hit something, like let's say this, you get a large truck in the car like this, the dashboard and everything is going to get crushed down on you and hitting your leg underneath the steering wheel there. So we're going to take the hood off, we're going to take the roof off to make sure that we remove the structural components of the car, and then we're going to actually roll the dashboard and pry the dashboard off of you to be able to get you out of there.
Thank you.
if you guys can see, there's so many EMS members right there, but they're putting a neck collar on the patient. So that helps keep his neck in alignment so that, again, we're just really worried about making sure that there's nothing, you're not getting jostled or twisted or bent or any way that could further exacerbate an injury that you might have sustained. So we did a lot of work in this car, right? We took four doors off, we took the hood off, we rolled the dash. This went pretty quickly, pretty smoothly. Everything was pretty straightforward here with what we had. This is not normally what we're dealing with. Normally we have the car in much worse shape than this. We took a sledgehammer to it earlier, which was a lot of fun.